here we are at the Shepherd Neame Brewery, just a few minutes away from starting to brew a very special beer. I was conscious of your email about peated malt and then smoky. You don't want a lot of smoky beer.
No.
So I've only put a little touch of peated malt in, I think only 3 kilograms, which is not very much. So it won't be you'll get a hint of smoke coming through, which will complement the brown malt, which is lovely in fruity brown malt. That's lovely. And of course, you've got the amber malt again, which is kind of orangey notes to the beer as well. So lovely, sweet, crystal. You've got some smashing malts in there. And the hops, of course, the real good mixture of hops are there. English Fuggles, Golding, UK Cascade, grown here. Yes, yes, yes. There's Cascade hops grown only a mile for this brewery. And we take the whole crop. Cascades. Yep, so it's UK Cascade. First of all, Dwarf Variety, Challenger, and Target. Yeah, so that's 6 hops in the copper. And we're going to add UK Cascade hops as a late whirlpool edition. Yeah, for aroma, and 250 grams in the whirlpool for more aroma. So you get a lovely aromatic hoppy beer, loads of hop aroma in it, and loads of lovely malt. So it should be a smashing beer. It's really sexy. That's it, make sure all those angles
Look at the camera.
Right, next. All good to go in. Six of the very best English hot prizes in there. Look at this. There we go. Nice one.
It's basically a plank of wood though, isn't it? I mean, is that a special?
What have we got here?
So this is, once all the water's drained through the mash, this is what's left. And this is going to, is it pigs? Going to pigs? To make pigs happy somewhere. Yeah, exactly.
As it comes near the top, you must see it get too much steam.
Yeah.
Right, yeah. And then, you know, you guys for this? You add it. Don't drop the plastic in. Now that's a whirlpool hops. A roll of hops. That's it. And then, bring this
down. Then are you good for us, Stena? Everything's calm.
Very nice.
You're doing a great job, Darren.
Well, you know, I'm doing my bit. I'll get into it. Get the top of coming over the top of the foam. Not really the yeast yet, is it? It's more the aeration. Coming over the top of a brewing vessel or fermentation vessel number two, which is going to be home to. Oh, we are, by the way. We are. It's going to be home to six of the best for the next 7 days while it commences. And it's going to condition for another 7 to 10 days before we stick it on the ship. Hopefully, sometime in the end of this month, September, and get it over to Stockholm. The last time we'll see it before it ends up in a pint glass in Akkurat. Exciting.
That's a wrap.
And that's a wrap.